Dean, I don't know whether ESP is real or not, but from what I've read, here's what I think is real, that if ESP is true, that it seems to not obey the traditional laws of the physical world in terms of space and time. It doesn't fall off with distance the way normal electromagnetic radiation or gravity would. It doesn't obey time. Sometimes the effect can be back in time or forward in time without change. Mm-hmm. And so that seems to indicate that if ESP is true, it's reaching into some non-physical mode of existence.
Mm-hmm. And in the 19th century, that would have been a reasonable conclusion.
I'm only 200 years out of date?
Well, we're in the 21st century. So in the 21st century, we have other ways of imagining how things can work. So it's quite true. A lot of experiments have been done in ESP to use very heavy electromagnetic shielding to block signals. And I mean, we've known now after a lot of data gathering that it's not signal-like. It's more correlation-like. And it's true. It doesn't seem to drop off with distance like an electromagnetic signal might. There are a lot of things suggesting that the classical way of thinking about this is simply wrong. And in classical physics days, of course, that was the showstopper. There was no place else to go. Mm-hmm. Well, now we have a more fundamental physics. The more fundamental physics, these are not showstoppers. In fact, they begin to point in the right direction. So we have non-local connections that don't require passing through anything. We have correlations that will spawn, not spontaneously, but correlations that will arise that are meaningful on both sides.
Without signals passing between.
Without signals. They're purely correlative. So we begin to see something like a beginning of a new physical substrate that previously might have been called non-physical because they didn't have any concepts for it yet, but now we do. So is current quantum mechanics sufficient to explain ESP? No. But is it a big step in the right direction for describing how these phenomena work in a kind of a quasi-physicalist idea? I mean, quantum mechanics is exactly not matter. So, you know, it's sort of informational. So perhaps rather than thinking of ESP as non-physical, we should think of it more as ESP as a reflection of an informational aspect of reality, which is somewhere between perhaps consciousness and hard matter as we're used to it.
Let's go through briefly the categories of ESP and see how that model might account for them. We know telepathy, communication between minds, clairvoyance, somehow knowing about a non-mental thing, some non-mental event, precognition, knowing the future, psychokinesis, mind over matter, being able to change dice or random number generators or something like that. That's kind of the spectrum of the ESP world, right? How then would this model encompass each of those categories?
Well, for one thing, the four classes of phenomena are sometimes thought of as actually different because you mentioned the 1, 2, 3, 4.
Yeah.
But actually, they could all be collapsed into the same thing. I mean, most of the theorists now working in this realm are beginning to see ways of collapsing all of these into one form. I mean, as in physics, where the grand unified theory tries to collapse sure. everything into one explanation, that's kind of happening here as well.
How does that work in detail?
Well, take, for example, the apparent difference between clairvoyance and precognition. Clairvoyance is the ability to get information from a distance in space.
Without an intervening
mind. Assuming real time.
Yes.
But actually, in practice, it's really difficult to do an experiment where you know exactly in real time that that's when you're getting it. It turns out, in practice, to be much easier to get it slightly ahead or slightly behind. And so, just from a practical point of view, it almost every case of a clairvoyance experiment, it is kind of like precognition. I mean, just conceptually, it's not that different. And also, if we take relativity at face value, then a separation in space implies a separation in time. So that's why.
And simultaneity disappears, yeah.
Right, so we've collapsed two. So what is telepathy then? Telepathy can be thought of as either a direct mind-to-mind form of clairvoyance, diving into this object yeah. called the other person's head, or perhaps it's precognition. It's precognition of knowing you've now learned what the other person said. So you're actually not getting a real-time transmission. You're getting something that verifies that what you thought they said. So it's recasting from the experimental design uh-huh. into something that's precognition. For a psychokinetic effect, perhaps the act of seeing something at a distance is quantum-like in the sense that the act of observing changes it. So if I observe a random system somewhere, that observation itself could change it directly, in which case we've now begin to see ways where we can fit together things that look to be different into one actual substance. Now, we can now put all of that and sort of start smoothing it into a quantum perspective where at base there's some kind of a holistic interconnected fabric of something, information or something. And so we have a unified form of unusual human experience, all of which involves strange interconnections. And we have a physical theory which talks about a holistic fabric in which everything is connected. So what's not to like?
Well, some would say you have one mystery and now you've tried to solve one mystery with another mystery.
Except that the two mysteries are so similar that it's true that in a sense you're kind of juggling mysteries a little bit. But the aspects of quantum mechanics that we know to be true, and at least what we know in ESP empirically to be true, they are so close that I think it would be a mistake to ignore the fact that they may be telling us something.
Look, I certainly won't disagree that it's interesting. I think both have problems. Certainly in the ESP world, that its own existence is questioned by some, and quantum mechanics, you know, can it exist in affecting a hot, wet human brain at many orders of magnitude larger, even in the neuronal synapse, which is very small, is still hugely larger where the traditional quantum mechanical effects occur.
Well, that's not completely true, because the number of types of systems where we see macroscopic quantum,
it's changing.
It's
You're
changing,
right.
And it's both in terms of the size of the object and the length of time of the quantum coherence.
Yes.
So if you think of this
under
now,
under very special conditions, not a hot, wet brain.
Right, but if you go deeply into the hot, wet brain, it's no longer hot and wet, right? If you go down to the level of the individual ions, that's at the quantum level. There is no heat. There's no wet there. It's single mm-hmm. ions. Yeah. So part of the issue is, how do you scale up into this object? And I would say, well, let's think of it a different way. How do you scale up experience? How big is experience? Well, maybe experience is a cascade of a single ion that goes in the right place, the right synapse at the right time, and a huge cascade is set off. So how would we think about this in terms of an experiment, say? If you ask somebody to tell you all of the different ways that they know to describe the natural world, you may be surprised to find that there's only a few hundred different ways, because it's not so different, you know. So that means that it may be possible to have the equivalent of, rather than huge amounts of information I need to transfer to you, maybe a single bit or two bits at the right time can push just the right part of your mind, your brain in this case, and cause it to cascade out in the direction that is going to give the right answer.
If that's true, what is the implication for ESP towards the physical world or the so-called non-physical existence? The categories seem to collapse.
Yeah. So maybe what we think of as the non-physical world is actually an aspect of physicality that we're just beginning to get new names for. So maybe quantum holism is a kind of physical world that also has aspects that look non-physical.